understood what is the concept of a product and the various product levels, let's understand how does a company actually differentiate in the products and different strategies it can actually adopt. Well, the product differentiation is the act of designing a set of meaningful differences to distinguish the company's offering from that of the competitor's offering. The number of differentiation opportunities varies with the type of industry you're playing in. The first being the volume industry. This is the one in which the companies can gain only a few but rather large competitive advantage. That is, the quantity is huge over here, it's more of a volume industry. The second being stalemated industry. This is the one in which there are very few potential competitive advantages and each of the competitive advantage also being a very small one. Hence, this is more of a smaller industry we are talking about. The third being a fragmented industry. Here, one in which companies face many opportunities for differentiation, but each opportunity for the competitive advantage is very small. And finally, the specialized industry. It is the one in which the company may face many differentiation opportunity and each differentiation can have a very high payoff or a very high market to themselves. Having said that, let's understand the four different techniques which a company can actually adopt or strategize. The first being offensive strategy. This is the strategy of aggression, which is usually employed by the firm that is not presently the market leader, but aspires to the leadership position in the industry. It acts as a challenger and the leader is mostly its target. It tries to expand its market share and utilizes all the elements of the marketing mix in attacking its leader and taking its position. Hence, it's a very open offensive strategy wherein the competitor is trying to remove the market leader from its current position and to occupy the position in turn. Second being the defensive strategy. This is the one which is generally employed by the leader of the market who has the compulsion to defend his position against the confrontation of powerful existing competitors or strong new entrants who try to remove the leader from the topmost position using their offensive strategies as already discussed. The leader has to maintain constant vigilance and defend its position against the attack of the challengers. And finally, the third strategy being the niche strategy. This is usually employed by firms which neither confronts nor defends. They are neither the market leaders nor aspires to be one. It cultivates a small market segment for itself with unique product offerings or services supported by a unique marketing mix. Small firms with distinct capabilities adopt this kind of a stance. A market niche to be worthwhile must have characteristics such as reasonable size, profit potential, and growth potential.